Hey all, how have you been? Welcome back to yet another cleaning and organizing video. Today I'm going to tackle my fridge. It needed to be cleaned badly and I've been delaying it. I'm going to take out everything from the fridge and empty it fully. This video is in collaboration with Meesho. Meesho is India's favorite app to buy products at lowest prices ever. Trusted by 1 crore plus users across India, you can choose from 50 lakh plus products across women and men's fashion, kids wear, home and kitchen, and many more. So come to Meesho app and get all products at Sahi Dam, because any product in Indian market is available in Meesho at the best price. In Meesho's words, Sahi Sahi Lagaya Hai. And with that, let's begin with the video. For cleaning the fridge, I'm using a DIY solution of half vinegar, half water and few drops of dishwashing liquid. This is very effective in any cleaning, especially the fridge, where we don't feel good to use store-bought cleaning solution which have so much of chemical that may leach into our food. I will spray the liquid on the cleaning rag and wipe down the entire fridge well. Also, I will clean the glass shelves with the same solution. Let's get to the organizing part now. It's important to know about the condiments that shall go in the fridge and those which can stay outside for proper utilization of the space in our fridge. Mayonnaise, hot sauces or ketchup etc. is best stored in the fridge to increase its shelf life. Baskets, Lazy Susan, containers etc. are a great way to organize your fridge effectively. Glass containers are a good investment if you like to meal plan ahead. There are different types that you get in the market. One of them are these ones which comes with bamboo lid and are aesthetically pleasing too. These has rubber lining inside which makes it airtight. I got two sets. One is round and comes in three sizes, 1200 ml, 700 ml and 400 ml. And the other set is rectangular and it comes in three sizes too. These are a set of 10 plastic jars with a black rubber lining lid. However, it is not dishwasher safe like mentioned. My only intention was to get something which is freezer safe, because normal glass jars often get cracked in the freezer due to extreme low temperatures, so this met my need. These glass jars also come with this beautiful bamboo lid and is airtight with the rubber lining. I have purchased all of this from Meesho and I thought the prices were a lot cheaper than other websites. I also liked the quality quite a lot, hence it was worth the buy for me. I'm going to clean and dry all of the containers and jars before I store anything in there. The door of the fridge is a good place to store things like garlic, green chilies, curry leaves or small onions that is used very frequently on a daily basis for easy access. I have mentioned this trick in a lot of my videos. Storing carrots in water keeps them fresh for a very long time, and I will show you how have the carrots revived itself when stored this way. It's also time to clean the vegetable drawer in the fridge. I'm going to use the same solution and clean the drawer. I have used this basket with handle to store tomatoes. We love tomatoes, so there is a lot of them. These silicone bags are one of my best buys recently. It keeps the vegetables super fresh for long. In here, I have kept brinjal, green beans, broad beans, and some extra green chilies. I store milk in a jug in the fridge. That way the malai comes out very thick the next day. It's not advisable to store milk on the door because that's the warmest part of the fridge. However, we are going to consume it soon, so it works for me. But it's best to store milk at the back of the fridge on the middle or bottom shelf. Another hack to store capsicum for long. You can wrap them in a newspaper and store it in the vegetable drawer. It will last you for more than a week. I have spoken about it so many times in my previous videos. Storing peeled whole onions in an airtight jar in the fridge is absolutely safe. I find it very helpful during rush hours. This shelf in my kitchen cabinet holds my condiments or sauces. Here I store things that can be kept out of the fridge and won't go bad even in room temperature, like soy sauce, all types of vinegar, olive oil, chili oil, honey, unopened Hershey's syrup, peanut butter, unopened jam, chili flakes, oregano or any kind of dry herbs, etc. I also have a lot of meal prep to do. The first thing I'm going to do is to make ginger garlic paste and store it in the ice cube trays and store it in the fridge in the jars I showed you. I'm also going to show you an easy way to make cucumber pickle just like the way we make sirka pyaz. Cut the cucumber into slices, add salt, pepper, 2 tablespoons of sugar, red chili flakes, cut green chilies, 1/2 cup vinegar, rest water and few cloves of garlic. To store spinach for long, another good way is to blanch the spinach. As soon as spinach is boiled, it will take 5 to 8 minutes. Dip it in cold water with ice cubes. This will help retain its nice green color. I will drain out the water and store it in an airtight container for later use. I'm also going to make sirka pyaz. To a container, I will add some small onions, ginger, green chilies, 1/4 cup vinegar, rest water, 2 big cube of beetroot for color, 1 tablespoon of sugar and little bit of salt. Here's another hack to store paneer for long. Submerge the paneer in water fully. This will help it stay fresh and soft. However, we would need to change the water every day. I like to cut butter in small cubes and store it in an airtight container, which makes it very easy to use it. Next thing, I'm also going to make this roasted tomato chutney. I will first roast the tomatoes on the gas flame, which will make it easy to open the peel. Then I will grind it in a chopper along with garlic, green chili, salt and mustard oil. Last thing for the night is to peel the small onions and store it in a jar so that it's quick to use. Today I also need to grind dosa batter and let it ferment tonight so that I can use it during the week for breakfast. Along with that, I'm also going to boil rajma and store it in the fridge so that I can make a quick lunch or dinner whenever required. Now let's do a small tour of my organized fridge before it's messed up again. In the first shelf, I have kept yogurt, buttermilk, homemade apple cider vinegar. In the basket, I have kept cheese, ready-made masala paste, chicken stock powder, etc. Also some leftover food from yesterday. In the second shelf, in this Lazy Susan, I have kept things like olives, red chili flakes, mayo, garlic powder, fresh cream, etc. Along with that, a jar with peeled onions, tomato chutney, carrots soaked, pickled cucumber, paneer sirka pyaz, blanched spinach, some coconut fried with jaggery, etc. The third shelf has the egg crate and beside is the space for leftovers. Below or the last shelf has the butter cubes, coriander leaves and spring onions. And that's all. Tonight's dinner is wangi bhat. I'm going to use the brinjal in my fridge, something I have learned when we moved to Bangalore, and I'm in love with this dish. In a kadai, I'll put some oil, and once it's hot, I will put some curry leaves, mustard oil, green chilies, and then onions and tomatoes. Once it's soft and well cooked, I will add the cut brinjal pieces along with salt, haldi, red chili powder, jeera, and coriander powder. And I will let it cook till the brinjal is soft and mushy, and then I will add the cooked rice. For breakfast this morning, I'm going to make uttapam for us and spinach egg rice for Kaya since she skipped dinner last night, hence I decided to give her something heavy in the morning. I'm frying the onions and one green chili along with spinach first. Then once it's cooked, I will add the boiled rice with boiled egg, salt, pepper and chili flakes. And our uttapam is also ready. We are going to eat it with some leftover aloo and coconut chutney. Now the toughest part, my freezer. It's been in a mess for long. I'm going to take out everything, clean the drawers and organize everything back. I will use these jars to store shredded cheese, frozen corn and peas. These silicone bags are also great for storing non-veg. Looks a lot better, though it still looks cluttered, which I can't fix it anymore until I get a bigger fridge. Anyway, I'm also going to refill the ice tray, take out ice blocks and keep it in the ice storage tray. For lunch, I'm going to make a 15 minutes rajma chawal because it's a very busy day today. With our house interiors being done, it's crazy. Plus, editing videos take forever. So, it's a more work and less cooking day. Because I had the rajma boiled in the fridge, it's going to be super quick. Ginger garlic cubes are ready to be stored in this jar. I'm also going to store cut coconut chunks in these jars for making coconut chutney during breakfast. Also, I will use the same jar for storing malai. I'm going to make ghee with it later.
You don't do this, you need to have spillage, okay?
What are you doing, Kaya?
Eating the pasta before Mama put spinach in it.
For dinner, I'm going to make spinach pasta for Kaya with the blanched spinach I have in the fridge. And for us, we are going to have fried rice along with some pickled cucumbers. That's all for today's one. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching and I'll be back with a new video very soon, this time I promise. Bye. Get your first order discount of rupees 100 or flat 30% off by using the link in the description to download Meesho. Additionally, you get free delivery on all orders, cash on delivery and easy returns also available. Ordering on the Meesho app is very simple. Just search for the product you wish to buy or look for the code of the product in the search box. Add to cart, select your payment method and add the delivery address. See, it's that simple.